Welcome back, everyone. This is Thomas Triple T Tie with another Noobulish crypto analysis. Before we dig in, remember this is edutainment and not financial advice. Additionally, when you find value, feel free to smash the like, ring my bell, hit subscribe, and leave your thoughts in the comment section. Let's dig in and take a look at Bitcoin on the weekly chart. Let me turn on my mouse. Mouse highlighter, that is. All right, so Bitcoin puts in the second bullish white / green candle here. Since I started typing and preparing for this video, the body got even smaller. It was slightly up here and then got squished down to here. If you look at the body, even though it's shrinking, it's also putting it's rising. The body is rising from where it was, from here up to here. And the wicks on these two weekly candles here, the two bullish weekly candle, the wicks are significantly longer on the top than on the bottom. That shows that with the rallies, there's downward pressure pushing it down. So that is something to keep in mind. There's a lot of downward pressure every time it tries to rally up and goes back down. When you look at the bottom wicks are really small and tiny. If this one's non-existent almost. This one's slightly longer, but nowhere near the length of the top wick. Bitcoin was able to break above the descending triangle resistance line here and then drop back within it for this weekly chart. More than likely, in a few hours, it's going to close with a bullish white weekly candle here. The next weekly candle will print somewhere out here, which is above the triangle's resistance line here. And that's slightly bullish, but more than likely it's going to continue on a horizontal channel trend like it has been doing here, between roughly 36.5K and up to around here, which is 44.5K. So it'll probably range in this area. And currently where this candle is in between the middle basis line for the Bollinger Band and the bottom of the Bollinger Band. It's smack dab in the middle. And it's also below the 50-week moving average, which is this pink salmon line right here. My nose is itchy. Let's take a look at the some support and resistance line. There is a near resistance line right here at 40.7K right here, and another resistance line above that most weekly candle tends to touch and then drops back down, and that's around 44.5K as mentioned previously. Support seems to be right next one's right here. It's 36.5, and the one below that is roughly 35K right around here. We haven't gone near 35K yet. We came close to 36.5, but we haven't gone below that yet. There's building pressure. There's building potential on the perpetual futures market, but we'll see. I described that in my derivatives video on YouTube. Feel free to check that out, or my Twitter. Let's take a look at below here and see what the indicators say. The white J line of the KDJ continues to go slightly up on an ascend above the blue K and the red D line. It went from 38.8K to 45.6K and 50K. Remove the Ks. 50 is the midpoint for the KDJ range. 80 is the top, start of the top, and 20 is start of the bottom. And I gave that a slightly bullish signal here. Down below, the MACD, the white MACD line, is continue below the red signal line, but you notice it's flattening out here. It went from negative 2,725 to negative 2,826, and the red line, I will zoom in here so you can see it. The red line descending faster right here. And so when this thing flattens out and this thing's still descending faster, what that's gonna do is they're gonna intersect sometime. And the white line more than likely will flatten out and bounce from the bottom and go back up. How many weeks does that take? At least a couple. It's been putting in at least, it's 15 bars of bearish bar, histogram bars so far. So it's bearish, it's printing bearish patterns here, but the way it's moving, it's bullish trending. That's why you got a bear and a bull here. The red RSI line down here went sideways from 42.2 to 42.13. I gave it a a crab and a bull here. The bull just says that it's trending slightly upward, even though it's more sideways. The aqua CVD, cumulative volume delta line, is trending up a slight bit from negative 4.022 million to 4,027,442. That's more a crab, but there is a slight bullish hint there. The white, this line right here, momentum or MOM indicator line, is trending up slightly from negative 11.9K to negative 8.5K. And that, again, is bullish. It's trending up faster than the other two indicators. It's bullish, but still, if you look at it as a whole, it's still crabbing sideways. So in summary, if the macro and the geopolitical environment remains similar to what it has been this week, then more than likely, Bitcoin will continue to chop between the 36.5 and 44.5K area. Something to be mindful of is with the average being around 39K. And that's in line with what the max paying prices are for options. But keep in mind that in the near future, it's predicted to move towards 42. FOMC meeting coming up on the 15th and 16th of this month, this coming week, may cause some choppiness hours before their announcement and hours right after. But that should stabilize afterwards in the next day or two. And the expected 25 basis point interest rate increase is probably priced in already, unless something dramatic is different about the 25 basis point. If they came in hotter or even lower, then that may change things. And that's about it. But before we go, let's check out the heat map for Bitcoin and get some buy zones and sell buy levels, buy walls and sell walls here. As you can see on top, we don't have any major sell walls up here. We do some fainted blues here, and this is consolidated or aggregate from different exchanges. We got one at 40, we got one at 42, but not major. The major ones are the buy wall. Those are sell walls up here. These are buy walls down here. The 35K one, the 38 one is getting brighter here. The buy walls here at 38K, it's getting brighter. But the major ones are at 35. It's been here for a bit of time. But you notice it's getting more yellowish, and it was more reddish here. That means it's getting smaller. And over here, we have the 32K that's been there for quite some time. And the 30K has been there for a long time. 29K is still there, although it looks a little bit, looks about the same. And the 28K, 25K is still pretty big here. 28K is so-so, not that big. So I'll screen capture this in my Twitter feed so you can get a closer look at it. But that's about where we are. I appreciate your time. And it's Sunday. I might take a break, but I might do another video later today. I haven't decided yet. I just want to make sure I manage my time properly to balance things out. I appreciate it. Ring my bell, hit subscribe, smash the like, and share your thoughts. Peace.